Welcome to my channel. If you are new, please hit the subscribe button, like, share, and hit the notification bell for updates of my new video. Let us begin. Our topic today is about abdominal aortic aneurysm, or known as the AAA. First, let us define. What is an aneurysm? An aneurysm is a localized sac or dilation formed at weak point in the wall of the artery. It may be classified by its shape or form. The most common forms of aneurysms are saccular and fusiform. A saccular aneurysm projects from only one side of the vessel. If an entire arterial segment becomes dilated, a fusiform aneurysm develops. Very small aneurysms due to localized infection are called mycotic aneurysm. Before going to the different characteristics or type of aneurysm, let us look at first the anatomy of an artery and its normal blood flow. This is the normal artery will look like. Let us have a closer look of the different characteristics of arterial aneurysm. First is the false aneurysm, or the pseudoaneurysm. These are abnormal outpouching or dilatation which bounded only by the tunica adventitia. The outermost layer of the arterial wall is shown. Pseudoaneurysms typically occurs when there is a breach in the vessel wall, such that blood leaks through the inner wall, but is contained by the adventitia, or surrounding perivascular soft tissue. Most common cause of this false aneurysm is trauma, such as dissection, laceration or puncture. Arterial catheterization accounts for most pseudoaneurysms. Biopsy and surgery.
True aneurysm is a bulging or enlargement of all three layers of the wall of an artery, intima, media, adventitia, due to weakened artery wall. True aneurysm is most frequently a consequence of atherosclerosis. It can also be caused by hypertension, vasculitis, congenital, myocardial infarction and syphilis, or other factors. Generally, true aneurysm are fusiform or saccular in shape. Fusiform-shaped aneurysm bulges or balloons out on all sides of the blood vessel. A saccular-shaped aneurysm bulges or balloons out only on one side.
Fusiform aneurysm refers to an aneurysm that has a circumferential ballooning shape. An aneurysm occurs when a portion of blood vessel walls becomes weak and subsequently dilates. In order to be classified as an aneurysm, the wall must balloon to more than 50% of its normal diameter. A saccular aneurysm, the ballooning will only happen from one side of the vessel. If an entire arterial segment becomes dilated, a fusiform aneurysm develops. Dissecting aneurysm is a splitting or dissection of an arterial wall by blood entering through an intimal tear or by interstitial hemorrhage. This is more common in the aorta. This usually is a hematoma that splits the layers of the arterial wall. These are the different types of aneurysms that may occur within the aortic artery. This video will focus only on the abdominal aortic aneurysms or the AAA. Abdominal aortic aneurysm pathophysiology. All aneurysms involve a damaged media layer of the vessel. This may be caused by congenital weakness, trauma, or disease. After an aneurysm develops, it tends to enlarge. Risk factors include genetic predisposition, tobacco use, and hypertension. More than half of patients with aneurysms have hypertension. Modifiable risk factor include tobacco use. You can always quit to lessen the risk. Hypertension can be prevented by lifestyle change. Common cause of aneurysm, atherosclerosis, connective tissue disease, smoking, infections, pregnancy, systemic lupus erythematosus, fibromuscular dysplasia, trauma, hypertension. Clinical manifestations, abdominal aortic aneurysm. 1. Only about 40% of patients with abdominal aortic aneurysms have symptoms. Mostly are asymptomatic. 2. Patients complains of heart beating in abdomen when lying down or a feeling of an abdominal mass or abdominal throbbing. 3. Cyanosis and modeling of the toes, if aneurysm is associated with thrombus. Clinical manifestations. Thoracic aortic aneurysm. 1. Symptoms vary and depend on how rapidly the aneurysm dilates and affects the surrounding intrathoracic structures. Some patients are asymptomatic. 2. Constant boring pain, which may occur only when the patient is in the supine position. This is a prominent symptom. 3. Dyspnea, which refers to difficulty of breathing or shortness of breath. Cough, paroxysmal and brassy. Paroxysmal cough is characterized by intermittent attacks of violent coughing. Brassy cough is a loud metallic barking associated with subglottic edema. Let us continue with thoracic aortic aneurysm clinical manifestations. 4. Hoarseness, stridor or weakness or complete loss of the voice, are called aphonia. 5. Dysphagia refers to difficulty of swallowing. 6. Dilated superficial veins on chest, neck, or arms. 7. Edematous areas on chest wall. 8. Cyanosis. 9. Unequal pupil. Clinical manifestations. Dissecting aneurysm. 1. Sudden onset with severe and persistent pain, described as tearing or ripping in anterior chest or back, extending to shoulders, epigastric area, or abdomen. This can be mistaken as myocardial infarction. 2. Pallor, sweating, and tachycardia. 3. Blood pressure elevated or markedly different from one arm to the other. Assessment and diagnostic findings. Thoracic aortic aneurysm, chest X-ray, computed tomography angiography, CTA, transesophageal echocardiography. This examinations is used to produce pictures of major blood vessels throughout the body, and is used to help identify abnormalities such as abdominal aortic aneurysms. Assessment and diagnostic findings for abdominal aortic aneurysm. Palpation of pulsatile mass in the middle and upper abdomen, a systolic bruit, may be heard over the mass. In addition to abdominal palpation, auscultation for abdominal or femoral bruit may be useful for clinical detection. Duplex ultrasonography or CTA is used to determine size, length, and location of the aneurysm. Assessment and diagnostic findings for dissecting aneurysm. Arteriography, computed tomography arteriography, transesophageal echocardiography, duplex ultrasonography, magnetic resonance angiography. For further details on this different examinations, further reading is suggested. Medical management. Medical or surgical treatment depends on the type of aneurysm. For a ruptured aneurysm, prognosis is poor and emergency surgery is performed. When surgery can be delayed, medical measures include the following. Strict control of blood pressure. Systolic pressure maintained at 100 to 120 millimeters of mercury, with antihypertensive agents, including diuretics, beta blockers, ACE inhibitors, angiotensin II receptor antagonists, and calcium channel blockers. Surgical management. An expanding or enlarging abdominal aortic aneurysm is likely to rupture. Surgery is the treatment of choice for abdominal aortic aneurysms more than 5.5 centimeters or 2 inches wide, or those that are enlarging. The standard treatment has been open surgical repair of the aneurysm, by resecting the vessel and sewing a bypass graft in place. An alternative for treating an infrarenal abdominal aortic aneurysm is endovascular grafting, which involves the transluminal placement and attachment of a sutureless aortic graft prosthesis across aneurysm. Nursing management. Preoperative assessment. 1. Assessment is guided by anticipating a rupture. Signs include persistent or intermittent back or abdominal pain that may be localized in the middle or lower abdomen, or lower back, and by recognizing that the patient may have cardiovascular, cerebral, pulmonary, and renal impairment from atherosclerosis. 2. Assess functional capacity of all organ systems. 3. Implement medical therapies to stabilize patient. Post-operative assessment. 1. Frequently monitor pulmonary, cardiovascular, renal, and neurologic status. 2. Monitor for complications, arterial occlusion, hemorrhage, infection, ischemic bowel, renal failure, and impotence. Gerontologic considerations. Most abdominal aortic aneurysms occur in patients between 60 and 90 years of age. Rupture is likely with coexisting hypertension and with aneurysms, more than 6 centimeters wide. In most cases at this point, the chances of rupture are greater than the chance of death during surgical repair. If the elderly patient is considered at moderate risk of complications related to surgery or anesthesia, the aneurysm is not repaired until it is at least 5.5 centimeters in wide. Constant intense back pain, falling blood pressure, and decreasing hematocrit level are signs of a rupturing abdominal aortic aneurysm. Hematomas into the scrotum, perineum, flank, or penis indicate at retroperitoneal rupture. Rupture into the peritoneal is rapidly fatal. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, like, share, and hit the notification bell for more medical surgical nursing videos.